So I'm joined here today by Steph Powell, who is your joint chair, aren't you, of the tech committee, Steph? Yeah. What about the anti-harassment work that you're doing, Steph? Just tell me about that. You know, what's within your kind of your powers to kind of try and spread the message on that issue?
Well, I think the key thing really is to start working with the anti-harassment club where possible. So, for example, one thing they wanted to do was to be able to spread the message of how to report it. And I think one thing we should probably look to try and do is trying to put maybe putting some notices up on buses or in places where people will be sitting and looking at things. I don't know, like GP surgery, or maybe in a local bar, if a local bar would accept it. And of course, that's where we can go out again to say that this is not acceptable and to report it any time it happens and every time it happens. And I think we should get into the sort of way of doing that and not being afraid to report it, because I think that's another big problem. It's the being fearful of reporting matters, and of course the bureaucratic process that has to ensue as a result of that. The whole idea of a case is quite daunting for somebody. But I think if we can do that, at least it would perhaps just plant the seed to someone to sort of maybe modify their behaviour.
At the end of the day, it needs to be unacceptable, socially unacceptable, doesn't it? Those comments, because I've heard them down, you know, St. James's Street in the past, and I've noticed that the people have just walked away, and you're thinking, well, maybe that, like, that was quite, you know, maybe that should have been reported, really, you know, particularly when people are under the influence of alcohol or you know, other substances. That's when you tend to, they seem to think people can say that they want, but if it goes unchecked, then it just carries on.
It's the same with any crime like that, isn't it, Mark? You know, if you're hearing anything anti-racist or homophobic or disablest, you know, it's a tricky one, because you know, you don't want to put yourself in any danger. And I always say that to people, you know, don't put yourself in danger. But if there's any way that you can quietly, discreetly, you know, everyone's got a phone these days, try and take a picture discreetly of the person doing this, or try, because that's the wonderful thing about phones, isn't it? They've got all these, you know, gadgets that you can video things or photo things, and just send a report in that way would be helpful, at least, or just to remember the words that were being used would be helpful. Because it could be something that this person's done before and is well known to services or to the police. So I think also, Mark, it's something about bringing these matters into schools, isn't it? I think schools and youth groups are important too, because, you know, that name calling is quite common, isn't it, in the school playground, you know, and it's calling it out at that age, really, and saying this is not acceptable for these reasons on all those fronts. Absolutely important.
Okay, we'll leave it there for now, Steph. Steph Powell from the Tech Committee. Thanks for talking to us again today. All the best.
Pleasure. And thanks. Nice to see you. All the best, and take care to all of you.